A commercial resupply mission to the space station honoring a spaceflight icon and an out-of-this-world experience right here on Earth. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. A Northrop Grumman Cygnus cargo spacecraft launched to the International Space Station on August 10th from our Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia, loaded with more than 8,200 pounds of research supplies and hardware. 2 days later, the Cygnus, named in honor of the late Ellison Onizuka, NASA's first Asian-American astronaut, arrived at the station. This is the company's 16th commercial resupply services mission to the space station for NASA. On August 11th, our Glenn Research Center held a dedication ceremony for the renaming of NASA's Plumbrook Station in Sandusky, Ohio, to the Neil A. Armstrong Test Facility. The event was led by our administrator, Bill Nelson, and featured remarks by several guest speakers.
It's our family's hope that the Neil Armstrong Test Facility will continue to vault us forward for faster and safer aerospace transport, and that this new name will be a beacon for the best, the brightest, and perhaps most importantly, the most determined.
The Armstrong Test Facility houses the world's largest and most powerful aerospace testing facilities and is the only place in the world that can test a full-sized spacecraft for the extreme conditions of launch and spaceflight. NASA is looking for crew members for the first in a series of one-year analog missions in a 3D-printed habitat at our Johnson Space Center designed to simulate life on a distant world. Set to begin in fall 2022, the series of missions, known as Crew Health and Performance Exploration Analog, could help develop methods and technologies to prevent and resolve potential problems on future human missions to the Moon and Mars. Learn more about this and other NASA analog missions at nasa.gov/analogs. Precision tracking data captured by NASA's OSIRIS-REx spacecraft has helped researchers pinpoint the future orbits of asteroid Bennu, which is expected to make a very close approach to Earth in 2135. With the ability to better understand the movements of Bennu, researchers believe the chances of it hitting Earth are very low through the year 2300. This development has also improved our ability to predict the orbits of many other asteroids that are potential impact hazards to Earth. A new online NASA visualization tool can show you what sea levels will look like anywhere in the world in the coming decades. The tool, hosted on NASA's Sea Level Portal, makes extensive data on future sea level rise from the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, or IPCC, easily accessible. It can deliver a detailed report for a location based on the most updated physical understanding of the climate system and climate change. For more details, go to sealevel.nasa.gov. NASA GLOBE CloudGaze is one of the agency's many citizen science projects that allow public volunteers to act as citizen scientists to help make important scientific discoveries. GLOBE CloudGaze uses detailed information from citizen science observations of clouds or dust storms that NASA scientists can compare with other data sources in the process of studying our atmosphere. Find out more at science.nasa.gov/citizenscience. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.